Myself Prashant, working as assistant professor in Government Engineering College Ramnagara. So I'll be teaching ideal gas, which is in module number 5. Okay. So coming to the objective, so you are going to study the ideal gas and you are going to evaluate the thermodynamic properties. The thermodynamic properties like pressure, volume, temperature, energy, internal energy, enthalpy, entropy, etc. Okay. So coming to the introduction of ideal gas. So what is an ideal gas? An ideal gas is a gas which has no intermolecular forces of attraction, and ideal gas obeys gas laws like Boyle's law, Charles' law, and any gas which obeys the equation PV is equal to RT is called as ideal gas. So coming to the Boyle's law, so Boyle's law states that volume of the gas is inversely proportional to the pressure at constant temperature. Okay, or we can make it equal, this equation. Okay, so V is equal to C by P by adding one constant C, or PV will be equal to C. That is what I have written here. So Boyle's law states that volume of the gas is inversely proportional to the pressure at constant temperature, and V will be equal to C by P, and PV will be equal to C. Okay, so for any two states, I can write P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. For any two states of the ideal gas, I can write P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. That is also equal to constant C. Next, Charles' law. Charles' law states that volume of the gas is directly proportional to the temperature at constant pressure. Okay, or I can write V is equal to constant multiplied by temperature. V is directly proportional to the temperature, and V will be equal to C by T. Sorry, V is equal to C into T. Or, okay, for any two states, I can write V1 by T1 is equal to V2 by T2 is equal to C. That is V by T is equal to constant. So for any two states, I can write like this. So another form of Charles' law is pressure of the gas is directly proportional to the temperature at constant volume. Pressure of the gas is directly proportional to the temperature at constant volume. So therefore, P is equal to constant multiplied by temperature. Okay, I have made it equal by adding one constant. Okay. Or what I can write, P1 by T1 is equal to P2 by T2 is equal to C. That is for any two states, I can write like this. The next one, ideal gas equation, also known as characteristic gas equation. Okay, let us consider a unit mass of ideal gas. Okay, initially at state point 1. Okay, here you can see the PV diagram. Initially it is at state point 1. Okay, and the initial process takes place at constant pressure. Okay, so in a PV diagram, the process 1 to I is a constant pressure. So initial state of the gas is 1. Okay, after undergoing a constant pressure process, the state has changed to state I. Okay, next, further it undergoes a expansion process, but this expansion is taking place at constant temperature, also known as isothermal process. That is from I to 2. See, in a TS diagram, if you see, 1 to I represents a constant pressure with an increase in temperature. Okay, whereas Next, process I22 is a constant temperature, so it's a horizontal line. In a TS diagram, the process I22 is a horizontal line because it's a constant temperature process. So the initially the pressure is P1 at state point 1, the pressure is P1, volume is V1, and the temperature is T1. Okay, first it undergoes a constant pressure process, okay, to state point I. Then after constant pressure process, there is a constant temperature process, also known as isothermal process, to state point 2. At state point 2, the pressure will be P2, volume will be V2, and temperature will be T2. Now let us consider first process, process 1 to I, that is a constant pressure process. So what you can apply, you can apply the Charles law. Okay, at constant pressure process, you know, volume of the gas is directly proportional to temperature, or V by T is equal to constant. For any two states, I can write V1 by T1 is equal to VI, because we are considering process 1 to I. So VI by TI. Or what is VI? Just simplify this. VI will be V1 into TI by T1. So that will be equation number 1. Next process, process I22 is a constant temperature process. Okay, therefore you can apply Boyle's law. So PI VI is equal to P2 V2. PI VI is equal to P2 V2. Or what is VI? It is nothing but P2 V2 by PI. Okay, so PI VI is equal to P2 V2. Or what is VI? It is nothing but P2 V2 by PI. So you have got equation 1 and equation 2. If you just compare these two equations, okay, left hand side, that is VI, VI is here. So you can equate right hand sides parameters. Okay, so V1 TI by T1 is equal to P2 V2 by PI. That is what equation number 2. This is from equation number 1. Now you know that, okay, just see here, TI is also equal to T2. How the TI, the temperature at I, state point I, is also equal to temperature at state point 2, because process I22 is a constant temperature. And similarly here, in a PV diagram, if you see, okay, process 1 to I, P1 is also equal to PI, because process 1 to I is a constant pressure. That is what here we have written, TI is also equal to T2, P1 is also equal to PI. Okay, you apply these two conditions to the above equation, that is this equation. So TI will be T2 and PI will be P1. Okay, and simplify. Okay, P1 on the right hand side, you take it to the left hand side. This will become P1 V1 by T1. T2 is there on the left hand side, take it to the right hand side. Okay, P2 V2 by T2. Or what I can write? So P1 V1 by T1 is equal to P2 V2 by T2. I can write it as PV by T is equal to R. PV by T is equal to R, which is known as a characteristic gas constant. Okay, R is known as characteristic gas constant. Okay, you should remember this. Characteristic gas constants will vary from one gas to another gas. Okay, so R value will vary, okay, depending on the gas. Or PV is equal to RT. Okay, here P is pressure, V is specific volume, R is characteristic gas constant, T is the temperature. Okay, so you know V is a specific volume. Specific volume is defined as the ratio of volume by mass. Okay, so here for V, I can write V by M, or PV is equal to MRT. M, if it goes to the right hand side, the equation will become PV is equal to MRT. This equation is the ideal gas equation, right? Next, Avogadro's law, and also we'll find out what is universal gas constant. The first, Avogadro's law, what it tells: under identical conditions of temperature and pressure, equal volumes of all gas have same number of molecules. Okay, So temperature and pressure will be same. Okay. So equal volumes will have same number of molecules. Okay. So what is the hypothesis? It states that 1 kg mole of any gas. Okay. We'll come to know what is 1 kg mole. 1 kg mole of any gas at NTP. Okay. Normal temperature and pressure. That is pressure of 760 mm of mercury. Temperature will be 0 degree centigrade. Occupies 22.4 meter cube of volume. And it contains 6 into 10 to the power of 23 molecules. It is called as Avogadro number. Okay, if you take 1 kg mole of any gas, it may be oxygen, it may be nitrogen, okay, or any other gas, it will occupy how much volume? 22.4 meter cube. 22.4 meter cube of volume, and it contains 6 into 10 to the power of 23 molecules. So 1 kg mole of any gas will contain how many molecules? 6 into 10 to the power of 23 molecules, and what will be the volume? 22.4 meter cube. So here I have written 1 mole is 22.4 meter cube. So if you compare meter cube and mole, mole value is more. The value of mole is more because 1 mole itself is 22.4 meter cube. You just compare the volume of the mole and the meter cube volume. So mole volume is more because 1 mole is 22.4 meter cube. Sometimes kg mole is also known as mole. Now, how do you define number of kg moles? It is defined as a ratio of mass. You can see here m stands for mass, mu stands for molecular mass. It is so number of kg moles is defined as the ratio of mass divided by the molecular mass. So mass, it is expressed in kg, whereas molecular mass is expressed in kg per kg mole. Kg, kg gets cancels. What is remaining? So kg mole goes to the numerator, it will become kg moles. So number of kg moles is defined as a ratio of mass divided by the molecular mass. Next one, molar volume. So it is represented by V bar. It is defined as a ratio of total volume to the number of moles. It is defined as a ratio of total volume divided by number of kg moles. Okay, V by N. Also, okay, we can write it as specific volume into molecular mass. Okay, again, you are going to get V by N only because specific volume is volume by mass. Molecular mass is mass by number of moles. Alva? Okay, N, how we have defined number of moles? M by mu, or mu is equal to M by N. Okay, M, illi specific volume andre V by M, illi mu andre M by N. M, M gets cancels. Again, you are going to get total volume divided by number of moles. So molar volume is nothing but total volume divided by number of moles. So small n represents number of moles. Also, it is given by specific volume into molecular mass. Idu banbitto small v represents specific volume, mu represents molecular mass. Okay. So you know v is the total volume, it is in meter cube. So N is the number of kg moles. So the unit for molar volume will be meter cube per kg mole. Meter cube per kg mole. Okay, next we'll find out what is universal gas constant. We know that PV is equal to MRT. Or what is V? What here V represents total volume. Okay, what is V? Okay, from equation 2, V is nothing but V bar into N. That is what I have written here. V is nothing but, okay, what is V? V bar into N. So V bar into N is equal to MRT. Okay, or PV bar is equal to MRT by N. N I have taken to the right hand side. Okay, PV bar is equal to MRT divided by N. What is M by N? Mass divided by number of moles is nothing but molecular mass. Okay, m by n is nothing but mu into r times t, because n we have defined as m by mu. Okay, number of kg moles hang defined madidive, n is nothing but mass divided by the molecular mass, or mu is equal to m by n. So mu into r into t we have got here. From experimental observation, it is found that the quantity molecular mass multiplied by the characteristic gas constant, okay, it is known by a name, universal gas constant. Universal gas constant, and you should remember this, universal gas constant will be same for any gas. Universal gas constant will be same for any gas. Only the characteristic gas constant will vary depending on the gas, whereas universal gas constant remains, the value of universal gas constant remains same for any type of gas. Okay, so here mu into r is known as universal gas constant. R bar is nothing but mu into r. Our equation 4 will become PV bar is equal to r bar t. R bar t also I have written the equation to find the universal gas constant. So R bar is nothing but PV bar by T. So pressure, okay, 760 mm of mercury pressure, if you take, it will be 101.325, okay, into volume is 22.4 meter cube, temperature is 273.15. if you just simplify, you are going to get this 8314.3 joules per kg mole Kelvin. Joules per kg mole Kelvin. In terms of kilojoules, it will be 8.314 kilojoules per kg mole Kelvin. Okay, you are going to get. Next, we'll move on to problems. So, first problem. A pressure bottle stores 5 meter cube of inert gas at pressure 10 megapascal and temperature 300 Kelvin. Make the calculations for mass, density, specific volume and molar volume of the gas. And yes, they have given the molecular mass also of the gas to be as 28. Right. So in this problem, what they have given? Volume they have given, because 5 meter cube. Meter cube is a unit for volume. 5 meter cube. Pressure they have given 10 megapascal. Temperature they have given 300 Kelvin. So you have to calculate the values. Okay, whatever they have asked. First, let us try to find the characteristic gas constant. You know, R is equal to R bar by mu. Okay, universal gas constant is nothing but R into mu. Or what is R? Characteristic gas constant will be equal to universal gas constant divided by the molecular mass. 8314 divided by the molecular mass to be as 28, you are going to get 296.93 joules per kg Kelvin. You know that PV is equal to MRT, so mass will be PV by RT. So mass of gas is nothing but pressure into volume divided by R into T. Pressure is, okay, 10 megapascal, 10 into 10 power 6, volume is 5. Characteristic gas constant just now you have found, temperature also you know, simplify, you are going to get mass 561.3 kg. Density of gas is nothing but mass by volume, you know. Okay, so density is defined as a ratio of mass by volume. Mass you have calculated just now, volume they have given in the problem, 5 meter cube, that is what we have put. Yeah, you're going to get density of gas. Specific volume is nothing but reciprocal of density. So, okay, just you can calculate, you are going to get 0.0089 meter cube per kg. Next, number of moles, small n is nothing but mass divided by the molecular mass. What is the mass? Mass we have calculated now, 561.3 kg. Molecular mass they have given in the problem, 28. Okay, molecular mass 28. Calculate. Okay, you're going to get number of kg moles, 20.04 kg moles. Molar volume is nothing but total volume divided by number of moles. Total volume is 5 meter cube. 5 meter cube, number of moles is 20.04 kg mole. Just simplify, you are going to get 0.2495 meter cube per kg mole. Important. Okay, so units are also important. Meter cube per kg mole is a unit for molar volume. Okay, so next we'll go to the second problem. So two spheres are there having capacity of 2 meter cube. They are connected by a pipe with a valve inserted in between. Okay, so third sphere is there. Two spheres are there and there is a pipe which are connected to these two spheres with a valve inserted in between. Yeah. So in between two pipes, okay, sorry, in between two spheres there is a pipe is there which is connecting these two spheres. In between the pipe there is a valve. So when the valve lies in the closed position, one sphere contains oxygen at 50 kilopascal and 320 kelvin. Another contains oxygen at 45 kilopascal and 290 kelvin. Subsequently, the valve is opened and the entire system is allowed to attain equilibrium conditions. Okay. So before opening the valve, they have given the sphere 1 pressure and temperature and the sphere 2 pressure and temperature. Okay. Now the valve will be opened and it is allowed to attain equilibrium condition. At this state, the final temperature is 300 Kelvin they have given. Okay, presuming that volume of the connected pipe is negligible, that means the pipe which is connecting these two spheres is negligible, you have to find the final pressure of the composite system. So third sphere ida, sphere madhya ondu pipe ida. Okay, pipe madhyadalli ond valve ida. Okay, before opening the valve, what is the pressure and temperature in one sphere and what is the pressure and temperature in the another sphere, sphere number 2, the takole. Okay, they have given, right? So when the valve will be opened, when the valve is opened, okay, after some time equilibrium condition will be reached. Okay, at that time what will be the temperature, that is 300 Kelvin they have given. You have to find the pressure after opening the valve. What will be the pressure anadna find out madbeku. Okay, so how will you find the pressure? So you know PV is equal to MRT using the ideal gas equation. Okay, you can find the pressure, but before we use PV is equal to MRT, let us try to find what is the mass of gas in sphere 1, mass of gas in the sphere 2, right? First we have found the characteristic gas constant, you know, R is equal to R bar by mu. So universal gas constant divided by the molecular mass. See, in this problem they have not given the molecular mass. Okay, they have told that it's a, the gas is here is oxygen. So for some of the standard gases you should remember the molecular mass. Oxygen is has a molecular mass of 32. So universal gas constant, you know, it is a 8314 joules per kg kelvin divided by the molecular mass. So you are going to get 259.8 joules per 8314 is joules per kg mole kelvin. Okay, here it is molecular mass k is nothing but kg per kg mole. So if you simplify, joules per kg kelvin bar 259.8 joules per kg kelvin. So here what we have represented is suffix 1 or suffix 2, that is sphere 1 and sphere 2. Okay, first we'll try to find what is the mass of oxygen in sphere 1. So m1 is nothing but PV by R times T1, because PV is equal to MRT. What is M? PV by RT. Okay, since we have taken first sphere, so ella suffix ellala M1, okay, P1 V1 by T1 R. Okay, both the spheres are having same gas, that is oxygen. So R we have not represented by suffix. So mass 1 P1 V1 by R times T1. What is P1? Pressure 1. Okay, that is a, what is a sphere 1 pressure? They have given now 50 kilopascal and 320 Kelvin temperature is there in the one sphere. Okay, that is what we have taken. 50 kilo means 10 to the power of 3. Volume 2 meter cube. R we have found out. Temperature they have given in the problem, that is 320 Kelvin. Okay, if you see here, one sphere contains oxygen at 50 kilopascal and 320 Kelvin. Okay, just we have put those values. Pressure 50 kilopascal is adana pascal convert madbeko by multiplying with 10 power 3. Volume is 2 meter cube. R you know, T1 you know. Okay, simplify, you are going to get 1.203 kg. Okay, that is the mass of sphere 1. Next we will find what is the mass in the sphere number 2. So mass of gas in the sphere number 2, P2 V2 by R times T2. P2 is 45 kilopascal kotidare, temperature T2 is 290. Just put it in the equation, get the value. Volume is same, 2 meter cube. Okay, even sphere 2 volume is also 2 meter cube. So you have got 1.194 kg. Next, so when the valve is opened, okay, both the masses gets mixed. So what is the total mass? M1 plus M2, 1.2 plus 1.194, okay, I think it is, okay, small mistake is there, okay, 2 point something will come, just calculate. Okay, around 2 point something kg you are going to get. Volume is nothing but V1 plus V2. 2 plus 2 is 4 meter cube. So this total volume is, sphere 1 volume is 2, sphere 2 volume is 2, 4 meter cube. Okay. Next, you know, ideal gas equation is given by PV is equal to MRT, or P is equal to MRT by V. Mass is 2.397. Okay, you are going to get mass to be as okay, ಇಲ್ಲಿ 1.194 ಹಾಕಬೇಕಿತ್ತು ಇಲ್ಲಿ, ಓಕೆ, ಅವಾಗ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬೈ ಮಿಸ್ಟೇಕ್ 1.155 ಅಂತಿದೆ, 1.194 ಹಾಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, 1.194, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ 2.397. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಸ್, ಟೋಟಲ್ ಮಾಸ್ 2.397, ಆರ್ 259. Temperature is 300 Kelvin. This temperature is after the equilibrium condition is been attained. So this 300 temperature has been given in the problem. Volume is 4. Okay, simplify. You are going to get 46.71 kilopascal. Okay, 46716 baruthe. In terms of kilopascal, you have to divide by 10 power 3. You are going to get 46.71 kilopascal. Next. MCQ, multiple choice questions. Okay, let us see. So what is a mole of a substance? Okay, so 1 mole as a mass numerically equal to half, 1 mole as a mass numerically equal to the molecular weight of the substance. Okay, so 1 mole is nothing but molecular weight of the substance. This is the correct answer. Okay, 1 mole as numerically equal to double. Okay, none of the above there. So 1 mole as a mass numerically equal to the molecular weight of the substance. This is the correct answer. Okay, next, what is the formula for number of kg moles of gas? Okay, so we have defined, no, number of kg moles is nothing but mass divided by the molecular mass. So here option B is the correct answer. N is equal to m by mu. Next, ideal gas equation. Okay, so that is PV is equal to RT. First one is a ideal gas equation, because you know PV is equal to RT. Next, according to Avogadro's law, what is the relation between volume of 1 kg mole of oxygen and volume of 1 kg mole of nitrogen at normal temperature pressure? Okay. So the relation between 1 kg mole and 1 kg mole of oxygen and nitrogen, it is same, volume is same, because in the Avogadro's law itself we have told that At same identical conditions of pressure and temperature, equal volumes of gas will have same number of molecules. So volume of 1 kg mole of oxygen is same as that of nitrogen. Okay. That volume is equal to 22.4 meter cube. 1 kg mole of any gas will be equal to 22.4 meter cube. So the volume of 1 kg mole of any gas will be same. So in today's class, first we have talked about what is ideal gas. Then we have talked about Boyle's law, Charles law. Then we have arrived at the characteristic gas equation, that is nothing but PV is equal to RT. PV is equal to RT. Then okay, we have studied about Avogadro's law and universal gas constant. Okay. Thank you.